走过失落的30年，日本央行在2024年7月毅然决然宣布升息，没想到却将日本导向金融风暴的中心。
The timing was spectacularly bad. Soon after, unexpectedly lackluster jobs data from the U.S. sparked fears the Fed had waited too long to start cutting rates.Panic spread among investors.
We've just seen the biggest one-day move on the Nikkei 225 since 1987.
It was clearly a bad day for stocks.
日本央行放鹰，颠覆外界预期。过去在国际金融市场备受欢迎的日元利差交易瞬间崩解，投资人忙着调整资金配置，国际股市也跟着震荡。
The stampede was so big.That the meltdown just exploded in a massive pile of losses for everyone. The yen, which everyone had been selling to fund this carry trade, surged in value.
美元对日元七月初万破160大关，原本被专家看坏，却在短短两个月内翻转。日元不但止贬回升，更一度升破140日元对一美元价位。日本民众的心情也跟着喜三温暖。
いきなり来たからみんな予想してなかったけど、僕らはやっぱ一応感じたね。
借り入れに対する返済に関してはとても不安があります。為替が10円変わっても外国のお客様は思案されるでしょうし、アメリカが利下げをされて日本が利上げをされると、私も本当に大変な状況になりますので。
日元强势升值对日本经济带来不小的冲击，特别是旅游业，先前受惠于便宜日元，观光经济蓬勃发展。现在日元甜甜价没了，少了汇差的吸引力，观光业者担心游客也会就此向他们说拜拜。
私は最近の株式市場に関してはもう本当に心配で、あまりもう見ないでおこうと思うぐらいです。日本が円安に振っても円高に振ってもどちらも可能性があるということで、私どもは準備をしておくしかないなと感じております。
在波动剧烈的金融环境下，日本民众对国家经济前景充满疑虑，但日本央行推动货币政策正常化的决心却十分坚定。
If we are unable to confirm a rising certainty that the economy and prices will stay in line with forecasts, then there's no change to our stance and will continue to adjust the degree of easing.
日本央行总裁植田和南八月时释出鹰派言论，表明升息的政策路线不会改变。但在市场从七月的动荡回稳之前，短期内日本央行不会祭出进一步动作。
Well, they want to normalize monetary policy. They don't want it all to go wrong the moment that they lift interest rates, which is what's happened in the past as well. So they need to really, really carefully, sort of prepare markets and prepare the country for that process in order that they don't stir up this kind of volatility and they don't upset the apple cart.
谨慎行事是2024下半年日本央行奉行的最高行为准则，特别是在全球迎接降息风潮的当下，逆风的日本央行面对国际金融市场和国内政治变动的多重挑战，要如何拿捏货币政策正常化的节奏，同时维系日本的经济动能，成了最大考验。